Each year, the Macquarie Australia Conference brings together capital and ideas for investors interested in the opportunities and themes playing out in the Australian market. In this, the conference's 21st year, I'm joined by Shemara Wikramanayake, Macquarie Managing Director and CEO, to talk about the investment landscape and some of the themes we've been discussing with our clients. These are very interesting times from a global market perspective, with the IMF talking about 2019 as being a most delicate year. I was wondering what you're hearing from our clients and how you're feeling about the outlook.
As you say, it's been a long cycle and we've had some signs that it potentially could be late cycle, so that creates some apprehension. But generally we're seeing from our clients that there's still many places where the world needs money and great ideas developing investment opportunities that are very attractive for capital investing. Speaking of the global economy though, you're the expert on this. What are you seeing in the various major regions of the world?
It is very uncertain out there. And in Q4 last year, we saw that markets became very nervous and equity markets in particular fell very heavily. But it's been interesting so far in 2019 that markets have rebounded quite strongly. And in the most recent data prints, it does look like green shoots are starting to emerge. So after a period where growth was really quite weak, it does look like things are starting to improve. In particular in China, there's been a big stimulus and that is starting to bear fruit. And in the United States, the Federal Reserve has become very dovish. And again, given that the US economy is still very strong and the labour market is very strong, I personally think the chances of a recession in the United States this year are very small. So you put that together, and whilst there are risks, particularly geopolitical risks, it feels like growth will be okay for the rest of this year.
What about Australia? What are the implications here?
The challenge Australia has, of course, is that in addition to the global headwinds, we have house prices falling at the moment, and that is starting to kick back into the consumer. So in the near term, growth is going to be soggy. But again, if you step out of the near term noise, Australia has many, many things that I think are very favourable to investors. We have strong demographics, we have strong population growth, we have a very stable political system. And in addition to that, the tyranny of distance is diminishing as global economic activity moves to Asia. So you pull that all together, and whilst in the near term there are challenges, Australia is still a very positive investment destination. Then against that backdrop, what are you hearing from our clients and how are you thinking about the outlook for investment in Australia?
Generally around the world, we have tried to play our role in connecting the capital of the savers of the world with unmet community need in areas where we have deep expertise, and those have historically been infrastructure, energy, some parts of technology, and also agriculture. In all those areas, there's still a lot of capital needed to be invested in Australia and around the world. The forecasts are that another $45 trillion investment is needed in infrastructure out to 2030. There's a 30% forecast growth in energy consumption over that same period, which will require $4 trillion of investment in renewable energy. And also in agriculture, there's going to be a lot of investment needed in global food production. And in all those areas here in Australia, we have been investing money both on behalf of our funds and the balance sheet. So in infrastructure, the funds have invested in transportation assets across airports, ports, rail, also in energy assets like the Endeavour Energy grid here in New South Wales, and in telecommunications towers. And in renewable energy on the balance sheet, we've invested in projects in wind, solar, waste to energy, and also supported hydro investment. And then in agriculture, we, together with the Clean Energy Finance Corporation and CSIRO, are working on developing precision farming across our 90,000 hectares of cropping land in our funds to drive better climatic and production outcomes. So we're seeing many opportunities here in our areas of expertise, but clearly we don't cover the whole spectrum. There are many other corporates here that are investing in our area as well as others. And we also, in terms of making that connection between capital and investment opportunity, are delighted to have the opportunity to host our Australia conference, 21 years of hosting it, where we bring that connection together across the entire spectrum of investment opportunity here in Australia.